please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
Oil marketing stocks. Okay, the first trade is about 0.15 higher, almost like the pre-market. So 10,530, and the Sensex is up 56. Again, very modest green tick. As well on the Bank Nifty, they're all shoulder to shoulder, just up about 0.12, 0.15. The mid caps are a shade better, and that makes the advanced declines look very good at the first tick only. At the first tick only. GAIL is actually seeing a bit of buying after yesterday's sell off. Infosys, now you can get a bit of a pattern. The IT stocks are higher. Infosys and TCS are among the green. Yes Bank has shown its some strength to the Nifty. Asian Paints is showing good colors. IOC is emerging, but I don't know how long that will last. Bajaj Finance, Hindalco, Indiabulls Housing, all of them continuing with their short covering bounce, you will have to say. Especially stocks like, in fact, even HPCL is in the green. So that looks like a bit of short covering coming their way. In the red, of course, Vedanta. But along with it are ITC, ONGC. ONGC is still not shedding those blues that it might be asked to, that it may be taxed on a windfall that doesn't exist. Bharti Infratel, SBI, Hero Moto, Indusind Bank, BPCL is not joining the other oil majors. Titan, Lupin are some of the companies that are in the red, but not a whole lot, about 0.5%. At the index level, we are still holding a 0.2% uptick.
Oh yes, and you know the stocks of the moment are Infosys and TCS, because both those stocks have hit new highs in trade today. Of course, they've been doing that for the last many days. But today, fresh highs seen on both Infosys and TCS, and now the gains for TCS this year have reached a whopping 35%. What a fabulous run that has been for the market leader. Apart from that, in the broader markets, you'd want to watch a couple of these stocks. The index itself, the mid-cap index, is mildly in the green. The market breadth is positive, 800 stocks on the advancing side. The stock of the moment is Gujarat Alkali. As I mentioned earlier, the results were very strong, 30% revenue growth, huge surge in margins, and that stock is now up almost about 11-odd%. It has United Breweries for Company. That stock is up almost about 3-odd% post its numbers. Jet Airways is seeing a bit of a bounce back right now. In fact, both United Spirits and United Breweries are doing well. Maybe the street likes the fact that the management of United Spirits has guided for a double-digit top-line growth. So there is some amount of confidence there. Apart from that, a couple of more stocks to look at. Pidilite is coming in for some pressure after the margins were a miss. Cummins, the domestic performance was a bit disappointing this time, so that one too is down. GSK Pharma is also in the red. Cochin Shipyard is doing pretty well post the positive commentary from the management. Sequence Scientific is following suit, so that stock too is up almost about 8% right now. Sudarshan Chemical and Mangalore Chemicals are also doing well. Otherwise, it's a flat opening for the market. But Anuj, clearly, I mean, the stars for now seem to be the IT names.
Oh, yes. And, you know, that's been the, you know, template for this market, Sonia, for some time. IT is the leader for this year. And that's been, you know, our prognosis as well. But Granules is down another 5%. And this really has been the accident of the earnings season. Ashwini, your thoughts on market opening and what's a good trade here?
Clearly, you know, IT has opened extremely well. And also, maybe NBFCs could be looking at a good day given the way Bajaj Finance has opened. So Bajaj Finance and NIT Tech possibly are the ones that you should look for upside on. But otherwise, today's day will be a bit more flatter than other days, or like flatter compared to yesterday. But IT seems to have gotten off the block fairly strongly. Yesterday, mid-cap IT didn't really participate. It was just, you know, Infosys, TCS. I think mid-cap IT could make up today.
Okay, and mid-cap IT, then what would you back, Ashwini?
NIT Tech, that's come off the blocks fairly strongly.
Okay, NBFC, I mean, it's not that Bajaj Finance and FinServ have done much. It's 0.7, and the other NBFCs are still just about languishing. GIC Housing, LIC Housing, those kind of PNB Housing. Not showing too much verve at this point in time. Would you only back the Nifty NBFCs, the big boys?
See, US yields have fallen below 3%. So, you know, that could play in also. And also, they've corrected quite a bit. So, from here, if the market has to rally, even the stocks which were correcting, even they would like to see short covering.
And the Nifty is trading above most of those technical levels. So we were looking at around the 10,538 odd mark. That's the Nifty Bank. Yesterday we conquered all these levels by the time we closed. And today as well, we're holding with some gains. The Nifty Bank as well, and in fact, the Nifty has conquered the 100 DMA. So that'll be a positive sign. We'll be looking at a close above those levels. And also, Reema, the 10,500 put, the addition over there is close to around 13 lakh shares the last time I checked. So there is a sense that now the bulls believe at least they can defend the 10,450 odd mark. The premium at the start of today was 55 rupees. Currently, it's come down to around 30 rupees. And the addition now is nearly 15 lakh shares. Keep an eye out there.
Yes, absolutely. Extending gains from yesterday. And look at the mid-cap index. It's been a one-way up move since the start of the trading session. Now higher by close to about 1-odd%. The advanced decline ratio is holding steady. Currently, we've got two stocks in the green for one stock currently in the red. So looks like a good end to the trading week, at least up until now. But let's take a look at the stocks which are making headlines this hour. MCX gains today after reports suggest they are in merger talks with NSE and that they could submit a proposal to SEBI this month.
And United Spirits and United Breweries, they trade in the green after posting relatively stronger numbers. The USL management guides for double-digit top-line growth.
Cummins slips on the back of weak numbers. Domestic performance disappoints, while revenues from exports jumps 30% on a year-on-year basis.
And Kochi Shipyard gains as the management tells CNBC TV18 that the order book for the next 2 to around 3 years is at around 14 to around 15,000 crores. While Granules continues to see selling pressure, the management says that raw material costs have gone up, prices and shortages, adds that FY19 growth will be similar to FY18.
In key earnings today, a decline in the U.S. business will impact Sun Pharma's earnings. Management commentary on Halol will be the key to watch. From the banking space, expect the asset quality to deteriorate for Bank of Baroda. While for Tech Mahindra, a CNBC TV18 poll pegs the dollar revenue growth at 2.5%.
All right, then. The market's virtually at the high point of the day. We are holding at around the 10,560-odd mark. So from yesterday's close, in fact, we have seen a big, big rally. We have IFCI that's buzzing around. They received close to around 280 crores from the Bhushan Steel Resolution. So good news out there. And that stock has moved up. Remember, it's been a rank underperformer. But for the time being, at least, it's seeing a bit of a bouncer as we speak. And the Nifty itself has moved to the high point of the day. So keep an eye out on a couple of those stocks. But let's get Ashwini Gujral. Let's find out whether or not you've missed the bus or you can take a fresh long position at these levels. Ashwini, putting together yesterday and today's rally, well, we've gained nearly around 120, 130 points odd. What would be the trade on the Nifty? Would you be looking to buy on a bit of a dip, or do you think the bulls have run their course?
See, in the market, if one bus leaves, another bus is always coming.
Mm.
So, Nifty, Bank Nifty, you know, it's going to be kind of choppy, although there is lots of short covering that's still happening. But today is a bit more sideways than yesterday. For me personally, we're kind of a little overextended. It would have been better if you could get some sort of, you know, decline so that you have, you know, some kind of a decent stop. From here, the problem is you suddenly have a 150 point fall and nothing has changed, but the intraday trader has been kicked out. So that way, I think more individual stock day. Consumption is making a very strong comeback. So
markets as well doing well. Nifty is up around 0.5%. Mid-cap index is up around 1-odd%. So it seems as though there's some amount of a comeback and pullback for the Nifty and the mid-caps. The Nifty itself is currently above 10,550. Lot of stocks to discuss today. We have the likes of Sun Pharma, Tech Mahindra, as well as a couple of others such as Bank of Baroda, which are coming out with numbers separately. The likes of Cummins, which are reacting to numbers, and even MCX, which is up around 5-odd%. Hi, Prashant.
Ekta, hi. So I think no more commentary needed as far as markets go. Let's bring in Mitesh Thakkar of MiteshThakkar.com, who's joining in for a quick technical check. Mitesh, good morning. Good to have you here. Your sense of the screen, we are bouncing off a little bit. Can it continue? How high can we go? How far can we go, actually?
Good morning, Prashant. I think this bounce back, which started yesterday afternoon, I think clearly with the bank Nifty leading has gained strength. The IT index was anyways doing well. So on balance, I think, you know, on an intraday basis, the charts kind of turned yesterday. I think the big test of this bounce back will come around 10,600, 620. And I'm still inclined to take or explore some shorting opportunities in case we fail to show strength or get past these levels of 10,600, 620. So while on a stock specific basis, I think we're trading with more of long bias, given the fact that a lot of stocks are reversing from oversold levels. But I think on the index around 10,620, would want to reduce some long exposure and even explore shorting at those levels with a stop just about 10,650.
So what are the levels that you're expecting on the downside for the Nifty, Mitesh? For example, what would be the range that we could expect at least?
I think, you know, after a big decline for the last about 8-9 sessions, this bounce back should lead us to about 10,650 on the upside, and on the downside, I think 10,425 becomes the support area. So maybe we'll spend a couple of days consolidating in this 200-220 point kind of range.
Ashwini Gujral is with us on the top of the show as always. Ashwini, you know, we spoke at 11:30, Nifty was up 50, 75-76 now. You're saying that it's likely, I mean, if to go long, stops are too far away, at some point there would be a dip and those dips need to be bought. Your thoughts, your reading on the screen now.
See, my sense is that this is some sort of macro news which is driving up markets, possibly a US bond yield, etc. Because otherwise, you know, you would have had a dip. So that way, you know, today's quote-unquote sideways day has not been a, you know, big one with big swings. And the market trading at a high point shows you that buying is coming back much sooner than expected. So chances are this should continue. And what's interesting is that now that IT and banks have already had their run, Reliance is looking to participate. You know, above this 921, it's almost there. You know, that should have a fairly decent run. So you have, you know, more legs of the market which are now beginning to participate. So I wouldn't be surprised if in the next 1.5 hours you have a large move from Reliance and the market again goes to fresh highs. So possibly first round of short covering done, more is on the way. Individual stocks, I would say, look at Hindalco, that's a buy with a stop of 239, target of 252. Reliance Capital is a buy with a stop of 388, target of 404. Reliance Infra is a buy with a stop of 414, target of 430. You know, since the mid caps have been beaten up so much, this sort of a rally will really give them, you know, wild returns. Like from the lower levels, things could go up 30-40%, a lot lower than where they came out from. But those are the kind of moves, you know, you should now expect given the carnage that we had.
After yesterday's triple century, today's even better, and 322 points higher on the Sensex. Things are looking really interesting at this point in time. And today, of course, even the mid-caps have participated. Actually, mid-caps have outperformed today. Sonia, hi, good afternoon.
Hi, good afternoon. Just when you think that the market is going to fall, the market comes and says, yeah, no, I'm not going to oblige you and I'm not going to fall any further.
You know, today has been even better than yesterday, because yesterday was, you could see it, it was only three or four index stocks which were taking the market higher. Today has been all about the stocks beaten, you know, black and blue. Mm-hmm. They are making a comeback. You know, housing finance is making a huge comeback. Stocks like SRF, they have made a comeback. Even Power Finance after pedestal earnings is doing well. So I think you can sense it, Sonia, Gen Irrigation, yeah, Adani Group stocks, ADAG. So perhaps a massive, powerful bout of short covering. And normally days like this tend to end at the highest point. So, and last anomaly is actually the best on these days. So let's see how it is.
But this tells you a lot about how volatile the market has become, right? I mean, a few good days, some very bad days, but still within a range, you think?
Yeah, within a range. But you know what this has done is at least put a bit of a fear into bears.
Yeah.
Till about 2 or 3 days back, it was, you know, almost a consensus call to just go out and sell the rally. Yeah. I think the last 2 days, the fact that the rallies, you know, if you sell, you've been taken to cleaners. I think that will be really interesting. We are very close to the 20 DMA now, that 20 DMA hold that, you know, I talk about. Let's see if that's taken out. That might lead to further short covering. Next week is expiry as well. So really promises to be really interesting expiry.
Interesting and very volatile. So this is the last 1 hour of what has been a volatile day for the markets. Let's tell you what all is lined up on the show today. We will be joined by Vinay Khattar of Edelweiss Investment Research to talk on macros and the markets. In key earnings today, Bank of Baroda, Cadilla, Sun Pharma and Tech Mahindra will be reporting their numbers. So we will discuss the key expectations.
Ashwini Gujral and Mitesh Thakkar now join us with closing strategies. Good afternoon. Ashwini, your thoughts should you take profit home if you bought in the morning or yesterday, or would you want to carry forward the longs?
You know, the way this has moved, it looks like there is some, you know, macro news which is triggering this. Otherwise, the bears should have been back. So now, maybe it's global bond yield, etc. Because this kind of short covering and no dip at all, macro news which is triggering this. Otherwise, the bears should have been back. So now, maybe it's global bond yield, etc. Because this kind of short covering and no dip at all throughout the day. Now, if you went long yesterday, I think today by the end, you should probably take some off. But I think there are still legs which haven't fired. So that way, you know, Reliance has not participated at all. I think if the markets give you even a small breather, chances are there'll be other stocks which will be taking over. But really to, you know, change your mind about the downtrend, we need to trade above 10,650 thereabouts, because often you've seen 2-3 days of such kind of moves and then the market low makes fresh lows. So let's not go there. This is a choppy range bound here. It'll have, you know, vertical declines and vertical rallies. So that way, for the moment, you can hold on to longs. I don't think you can take fresh longs. But for the last hour, what I'm looking at is, you know, RIL participating. It's had 6-7 down days right near its 200. I think last hour should make it participate. That is a buy stop of 910, target of 945. ITC is a buy with a stop of 269, target of 284. And India Bulls Housing is a buy with a stop of 1120, target of 1180.
Okay, so you mentioned that this 10,650 level needs to be crossed to get a confirmation that the downtrend is over. We're not too far away. I mean, it's just 30 points away, Ashwini. If that does happen, then what are the stocks or, you know, what are the pockets that you would look to buy into?
See, basically, the stocks which have come down the hardest will bounce the hardest, as we've seen. You know, all kinds of mid-caps fell because mid-caps were under pressure. So you have to get into those mid-caps which have come off sharply in metals, in a variety of spaces. But what's clear is that IT and FMCG, they continue to make fresh highs, even while the market is about 5% away from previous highs. So if you want a sharp bounce back, you'll get in stocks which have been sold brutally, like housing finance. India Bulls Housing could have a 200-point rally and nothing changes.
Oh, yeah,
but
that
clearly those 30 stocks are going to make new highs.
Actually, that is what I was asking you, Ashwini. This India Bulls Housing Finance move, would you want to extend it to the other housing finance stocks as well? The likes of Canfin or, say, LIC Housing, or it's just India Bulls Housing?
See, that's true for everything. Everything has collapsed vertically, 8, 10, 12 sessions. Ajanta Pharma, you know, SEAT. All of these guys can at least have a 10 to 15% rally and nothing would change on the longer term chart. So that way, you know, this mid-cap rally could be more extensive than, you know, people can imagine.
Counting down to the close of what has been a really volatile week, I must say, by the end of this week, the mid-cap index has recovered some of its losses, but it is still down about 0.5% this week. When we started off the day, yesterday rather, it was down about 2-odd% or so, but now about 0.5% lower. Ashwini, after the volatility that we've seen this week, do you reckon that this chopping around could take place next week as well? And how do you position yourself ahead of that?
See, for the moment, you should take long positions home. Now, whether this is the real thing or it's short covering, you know, that time will tell. But I think next week you should be positive. Lots of people short and they will get cleaned out. So more the number of shorts, the bigger the rally. Mm-hmm. So I would think at least Monday, Tuesday, you should still be in a positive bent of mind.
Okay. What about these metal names, Ashwini? Hindalco was one of your last hour call. But Tata Steel as well and a couple of others also moving up.
See, global risk on means that, metals also, which are coming out of fairly strong corrections, should move to the upside. So my sense is even on Hindalco, we could get back to, you know, 265, 270. And just because short positions are there, you will get those spiky rallies. Similarly, Tata Steel, etc., 615, 620, all that can happen. So my sense is short covering is still there and will continue next week.
Let's wait for markets to do that, Sonia, yeah. Because, you know, 2 days back, you could have easily taken a call that, you know, it's going
shorting
down further
the
down.
Money,
exactly.
Yeah.
And in 2 days, the Nifty is up 200 points. The Bank Nifty is up 600 points in 2 days. I think today's mid-cap action should soothe some nerves, Sonia. But that, I think, point is something which we'll find out, of course, next week, whether it was a flash in the pan or whether indeed we have a bit of a bottom in place. But for today, a lot of large cap moved, of course. So stocks like IndusInd Bank, Yes Bank, from the financials, Indiabulls Housing Finance had a big move. Commodities made a move. IOC, Hindalco, ONGC, HP, BP, all these stocks, GAIL, Hero Motor Corp, M&M, a lot of these stocks were higher. On the way down, not too many stocks actually, if you take a look at stocks moving down, only ITC perhaps, and you may want to add ICICI Bank. The interesting stock of last hour, of course, was State Bank of India. Now, it will show you flat, but intraday move on State Bank of India was quite interesting. And a couple of these erstwhile favorites are making a bit of a comeback. Eicher Motors, for example, was up about 2.5% in trade today. Maruti, after a long time, we're seeing that kind of move, 2% higher on Maruti. And even a beaten down stock like Tata Motors was up about 2%. But today was a much broader participation. Mid-cap stocks also did well today.
Yes, they did. So the mid-cap index itself, okay, by the end of it, the mid-cap index was up 2%. That's the kind of rally that we saw today. And, you know, we had phenomenal movers, really. I mean, Page Industries was just one of them. Spectacular numbers there. Stock closed up well in the green. Just Dial, Castrol, Exide, Adani Power, Torrent Power, Avenue Supermarts. A lot of these companies have been beaten down and they kind of saw a recovery in trade today. Cadila Health as well reported a good set of numbers, so that stock too ended in the green. And we do have a lot of others, you know, Gateway District Parks was up 20%, MCX, etc. So it's really, really good day for the broader markets. Let me just check if there were any stocks that ended in the red. You had Granules India posted numbers, it was down. IDBI Bank, that was a disaster this quarter, so down about 2.5%. And that's about it really, very few and far between the losses. It was mostly a day where the bulls made a lot of money. The Nifty goes home with almost a century intact, 97 points to be precise. And the advanced decline ratio was also solid. Before we wind down, we just have about 6 more seconds to go. Ashwini, for Monday's trade, anything that stands out as something that you would trade on the long side?
See, you cannot have another today-like day on Monday. So my sense is you should get some amount of dip before the market moves on. So if you buy, the market opens again 20 points higher, you buy there, you risk a, you know, 50-70 point dip. Already IT seems to be kind of giving up a little bit. But I think wherever people were short, like Ajanta, SEAT, Indiabulls Housing, etc., those stocks and mid caps will continue to outperform. So you have to look at, you know, the worse the decline, the better the rally that you will get. So chances are the defensives kind of back off, and you know, stocks which are weak, they take over.
Okay, Ashwini, thanks a lot. Have a good weekend. Mitesh, your thoughts, your final comments for the trade, and does that change the overall texture?
I think it kind of changed yesterday, and I think, you know, we did see good follow through today. Though we have not closed above 10,620, the breadth has kind of improved, which gives me a lot of comfort. Of course, I would want to see 10,620, 630 being captured. But the mid cap segment is coming back nicely, and I think, you know, that could see that despite some volatility, even if you, you know, kind of face 1-2 day supply at resistance levels, I think eventually we should be able to break beyond these levels. A word on Page Industries, Anuj, I think I wanted to comment on that. Very good bullish pattern is being formed over there. The highs for the stock are closer to about 25,500, 600 zone. I think once that is crossed, I think this is a stock which can easily do 28,000, possibly 30,000.